Morning, everybody. It's so wonderful to see you. It is such a gorgeous day here in Vermont, and it's good that we're all together and that we get to share a little time beforehand. I'll be certain to leave it on for a little while afterwards, so if you want to say anything else that you didn't get a chance to say to each other, you'll have that opportunity. Today is also, we are in the midst of Memorial Day weekend, and this is a weekend, and tomorrow in particular, a day devoted to remembering the lives of those who have been lost in service to our country. And this weekend, there's also, the nation is marking a day to remember and give thanks for the lives of and grieve those who've lost their lives to COVID-19. So they are in our prayers also today. Again, the offer stands to please let folks know that you may be in touch with who are experiencing challenges, that we as a church are here to assist them, and be sure to give them our number or email, and we would be happy to help them in whatever way we can. Next Sunday is Pentecost, and so I'd invite everyone, if you have something red to wear or something red to put in your background, I'd encourage you to do that. It will be a joyous celebration, and hopefully you'll be able to be with us for that. I'm now going to invite us to, in the midst of the comfort and the safety of our homes, to take a deep breath, and as we begin our service of worship with our opening hymn, and I'm going to unmute Mary and invite us all to join in singing, "Blessed Be the Tie That Binds." Mary. Scott, are you? We can't hear. Mary, can you hear me? She's not hearing me either. Is everybody else hearing me?
Yes, we can sing anyway.
Okay. Well, Mary's muted herself. She doesn't know that, and I can't get her attention. So we're just going to let her play through once. It's not a long song, and then I'll ask her to unmute herself, and we'll sing along with her.
Kathy, do you have the hymn number?
No, I don't. I'm sorry. I can find it for you if you need me to. Mary, you did not hear. No, you were muted. You muted yourself. Don't touch yourself. Don't touch yourself. Leave yourself
okay. Do you guys hear me at all?
No, nothing, because you muted yourself. So you have to start all over again. I just told everybody that we would start again. So you played through the whole thing. I'm sure it was lovely, but we're going to ask you to do it again.
We'll do it again. Somebody just...
If you could hold one second.
It's three verses, right?
No, it's two verses.
Two verses, okay.
You five, ready? 5, 7, if you're following in your hymnal. Okay, Mary, go for it.
Try it again.
Try it again.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Called to be one with Christ, called to be one with each other, called to be one in ministry, we gather in the unity of God's Holy Spirit, who calls us here. Let us now say together the words that Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Hey, Scott, can you see if you can unmute everybody? Because I'm having trouble with it.
We can unmute everybody.
Thank you, Scott. So now it's time for us to lift up the joys and concerns we're aware of. I will start and let you know that today we pray for another church, and it's our friends up at the Congregational Church of Rupert and their pastor, the Reverend Dr. Steve Berry. Obviously, I want to give thanks for the gorgeous beauty that surrounds us that we so often take for granted, and today is a day certainly to offer our thanks to God for it. By way of concerns, Kathy has asked us to pray for her son's fiance, Christine, who was in the hospital this week for several days with severe back issues. And it's been in a lot of pain. So we pray for Christine. We also are mindful of all of those who died in service to this nation, and we hold them, their families and their memories in our prayers, as well as the 100,000 Americans and over a million folks worldwide. And we are mindful of the 54, especially here in Vermont, who have died of COVID-19. So we hold all of those folks and those who loved them in our prayers. Other joys or concerns anybody has that they would like to offer?
I have.
And tell me, say your name so I go to you.
This is Allison. I have one.
Okay. Go ahead, Allison.
My friend's mom, Barbara, had open heart surgery this week, and she's doing well, but hasn't come home yet. She's supposed to come home tomorrow. So I'd just like to lift her and her family up in our prayers.
Okay.
Harriet?
Yes. Go ahead, Karen.
Harriet.
Oh, Harriet. Hi, Harriet. Sorry.
Go ahead. Hi, guys. Hi. I would just like to lift up the lives that were lost during the war that was important, that was most involved in my generation, the Vietnam War, to remember those folks who gave their lives not so long ago, but a long time ago, and who've missed living with those of us who are still here who remember them. Thank you.
Thanks, Harriet. Others?
Phyllis.
Kathy.
Phyllis, go ahead.
I wanted to share a joy that my brother is on the game and has been out doing some of the activities he is accustomed to.
Phyllis, your brother's Stuart. Name is
Stuart.
Stuart? Yeah, Stuart. Go ahead, Fred.
All those that are going back out for the first time in a while, remember to keep common sense out there, still use safe practices and whatever, and don't take it lightly because it hasn't gone away.
Thank you, Fred. Others? Then I will.
Karen, you're muted. We can't hear you.
I'm sorry. Does somebody else have something to say?
Karen Underhill is trying to talk and we can't hear her.
Hold on.
She's got to unmute herself.
She's got to unmute. I'm going to ask her to unmute. Karen, unmute yourself.
I just did.
Okay.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Now we can.
Just prayers for dear Henry, who is going to be having a procedure to check on his valve replacement this Thursday. So okay. We all want to keep Henry in our prayers.
Thank you. Anybody else? Then I'm going to mute you all and offer these up names and those we've thinking about in prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, we admit that we have not always been eager to follow you into uncharted territory. Yet now we are impatient and do not want to wait to find out where you are leading us next. You call us, you commission us, you empower us to be your witnesses. In the midst of that witness, we know that we are surrounded by people who bring joy to our lives. We offer up our thanks this day for the blessing of the Congregational Church of Rupert and their pastor Steve, for the fact that Stuart is doing better, and we hope that his healing will continue, and we lift that his health up in prayer. And we also give thanks this day for the beauty that we get to live in and among. Oh God, we offer our prayers for your church, striving to be faithful in the places you have planted us, even when we are apart, even behind closed doors, even in virtual space. You give us loving hearts that hurt at times when there are those we care about who are struggling or suffering or grieving. Today we lift up especially all those who have died in service to our country, especially we are mindful of those who died in the Vietnam War, and we recognize that there are many around us who have lost loved ones, and so we hold them close to our hearts. We also lift up all of those who have died of COVID-19. We are especially mindful of our 54 fellow Vermonters who have died. We also pray healing prayers this time for Christine and Barbara and Henry and all those others we know who are dealing with health issues or life concerns. And we also hold in prayer all of those who are venturing out into the world as things slowly open. We ask that they would be protected and be safe, and we join them in hoping that we will continue to all take good care of each other as we venture out into the world. Oh God, your power of resurrection life is greater than we can fathom, and we pray that it would be visible through and among us, even in these days, even in our scattered places, even in the midst of the mystery. In the power of the Holy Spirit, we remake your body once again, and pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. This is an offering plate, one that you haven't seen in person for now. I believe this is the 11th Sunday that we haven't been together in person, but obviously together in spirit. And so I'd invite you to consider sending in your gifts or using an electronic option to contribute to the work of the church that certainly continues. I'm now going to unmute Patty, and she's going to offer us a special piece of music called He.
He can turn the tides and calm the angry sea. He alone decides who writes a symphony. He lights every star that makes our darkness bright. He keeps watch all through each long and lonely night. He still finds the time to hear a child's first prayer. Saint or sinner call and know he knows the way we live. He'll always say, I forgive. He can grant a wish or make a dream come true. He can paint the clouds and turn the gray to blue. He alone knows where to find the rainbow's end. He alone can see what lies beyond the bend. He can touch a tree and turn its leaves to gold. He knows every lie that you and I have told. Even though he knows the way we live, he'll always say, I forgive. I
Thank you, Patty. I'm now going to unmute Jeff and invite him to offer our scripture reading today.
I'll be reading once again from the New International Version, John 17, verses 1 through 12. After Jesus said this, he looked toward heaven and prayed, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that your Son may glorify you. For you granted him authority over all people, that he might give eternal life to all those you have given him. Now this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I have brought you glory on earth by finishing the work you gave me to do. And now, Father, glorify me in your presence with the glory I had with you before the world began. I have revealed you to those whom you gave me out of the world. They were yours, you gave them to me, and they have obeyed your word. Now they know that everything you have given me comes from you. For I gave them the words you gave me, and they accepted them. They knew with certainty that I came from you, and they believed that you sent me. I pray for them. I'm not praying for the world, but for those you have given me, for they are yours. All I have is yours, and all you have is mine. And glory has come to me through them. I will remain in the world no longer, but they are still in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them by the power of your name, the name you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one.
Thank you, Jeff. What do our prayers say about what we believe? There are prayers that we know so well, like the Lord's Prayer that we just said together, where our lips moved in unison, but our hearts were drawn, depending on what's happening in our lives in the world, to certain key phrases within it. What is God's will that will be done? If we are not led into temptation, will we still be able to avoid it? What if we have our daily bread, but other people we know don't? There are times when we pray to God for strength or hope or peace of mind. And then there are the days when words fail us. There's so much we want to tell God that we don't know where to begin. Or we feel so lost or troubled or angry, we don't even dare express in words what we are embarrassed to admit we need from God. When we're feeling distant from God or so hurt that we can't manage to face God, we rely on the prayers of others to carry us and maybe keep that line of communication, however small, like a place setter, open for that time in the future when we will be able to pray again. For the last few weeks, we've been hearing Jesus' farewell speech, and now it's time to wrap it all up with a closing prayer. Those listening in to Jesus' prayer at the table of that final meal, hear Jesus' love for them shining through. He sees these disciples as God sees them and wants God to watch over them when he's gone. Jesus' prayers, like all our prayers, speak to what we believe about God and the kind of relationship with God that we live into. The most important thing that the disciples then and we as followers now hear is that we know God through Jesus's life and ministry. That is, we will know God by love. Jesus is bridging this life and the next. And what he intentionally offers in this overheard prayer about the back and forth between God's kingdom and this earthly world is that we can count on God's grace no matter how big a mess we make of things. That deep, all-encompassing love is ours to accept and to emulate. Jesus says to God that he was giving glory to God by the work he was called to, in the hurting lives of that he touched and made better. Father Richard Rohr puts it this way: we cannot jump over this world or its woundedness and still try to love God. We must love God through, in, with, and even because of this world. If we go looking for Jesus's legacy at work in this world, we can find it in those who are caring for COVID-19 patients, putting physical comfort and their own well-being on the line. Such a love, though, is not only limited to healthcare professionals, but to a wide range of workers who have been making it possible for the rest of us to stay safe at home. The wearing of masks by everyday folks is an act of love. We know that they are not necessarily going to protect us from the virus. Rather, they are going to protect others from what we could unknowingly share. This is love of neighbor on an epic scale. Stranger loving stranger, the served loving those doing the serving. May we strive to hold on to that spirit of love for other people even when this pandemic comes to an end and we take off our masks. Jesus prays that they may all be one in the same way that he and God are one. May our shared humanity, as well as the grace upon grace received from God, unite us in loving care for one another. Let us lift up now these words of prayer written 6 centuries ago by Thomas à Kempis. O Lord, let your love dissolve my hard heart. Let your love raise me above myself. Let your love reveal to me joy beyond imagination. Let my soul exhaust itself by singing the praises of your love. Let me love you more than I love myself, and let me love myself only for your sake. And let me see your love shining in the hearts of all people, that I may love them as I love you. Amen. In that spirit of abiding love, I would invite us to join together in our closing hymn, Let There Be Peace on Earth. Mary, don't touch it, Mary. I'm gonna unmute yourself. Unmute yourself.
Okay, there you go. Can you hear me?
We can. I'm used to muting and unmuting you, so you're doing it for me. So that's why we're getting confused. Go ahead. We can hear you now.
Kathy, you're muted. We can't hear you.
I thought I unmuted myself. I hit the wrong thing. Sorry. I'll start all over. Call to be one. We go forth in unity and love. Called to be strong, we go forth in the power of the Holy Spirit. Called in devotion to God, we go forth in ministry and witness to the world. Let us go forth in peace and love to serve God and God's people. Amen. Now, hey, Scott, can you unmute everybody? I'm having trouble unmuting. I don't know what my mute issue is. If not, everybody can try to unmute themselves because I don't know why, but there we go. Okay, we're all set.
For some reason, I'm muted by host.
I muted the host.
Yes. There we go.
All right. Well, happy Sunday, everybody. Happy Memorial Day.
And Memorial Day.
Peace. Memorial Day.
Happy Memorial Day.
Why today? It's supposed to be raining tomorrow.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, I didn't read that.
Well, okay. I didn't.
No. You gotta unmute yourself.
I'll plant some posies today for the rain tomorrow.
Underhill, unmute yourself.
Bye, Karen.
Bye. Have a good week.
Bye. Bye, Russ.
Have a good week.
Hey, Carolyn.
Bye, everyone.
I saw Leanne in a minute.
Yeah, you did. He said hi.
Hey, Charlie.
Hi, Harriet. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good to see Harriet. You.
Hi, Harriet.
Hi, Aunt Carol.
Have a good week.